as we have seen in the definition of effective value. We want to find out effective value in terms of peak value. So effective value of AC is that value of a steady current which will doing same amount of work as done by AC during one cycle. During one cycle, the time taken is t second. Okay? For the same time, we will ask effective value to do the work and AC value to do the work. First, AC current, how much work will be done by AC? Work done by AC. The formula for work done is I square into R into T. I square into R into T. But here what happens? There is no fixed value of I. I keeps on changing. So we take any one value which is known as instantaneous value, and that value continues for a very small time dt. So we get a very small value of work done here. So we write here dw is equal to instantaneous value I square r for a very small time dt. Then the work done, we want to find out the full work done. How do we get it? Answer, we get it by integration. So integration of dw is equal to I square r dt integrated. And for how much time? This is variable 0 to t. All these are constants or variables. So here we find I is a function of time. R is not a function of time, that is a constant that will come out. So what do we get here is dw integration is equal to r, and this is integration of I square. Now I has a value I naught sine omega t. This we knew earlier, that this current, what is its equation or what is its relation with respect to time? I is equal to I naught sine omega t. This is AC equation. The current keeps on changing with respect to time. This we call instantaneous current, this we call peak current. So in the place of this instantaneous current, we keep this value which is a function of time, I naught sine omega t, and this is square, so we make it square and dt. So this is equal to r. Now I naught is a peak value, so it's a constant, it will come out r I naught square, and integration for sine square omega t. To make the integration of sine square omega t, we convert it into another term which is not a square. So this will be 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2 and into dt. Next term is r I naught square. This is a trigonometrical identity we have used. Now we multiply this dt with both. This 2 we take out, 2. It's a constant. So here it will be dt minus cos 2 omega t dt. This is to be integrated, or we can say this is to be integrated by parts. Okay, now integrate this. So this is equal to integration of dw is the total work done. So total work done during the time is equal to integration of dt, that is t, 0 to t, minus integration of cos 2 omega t is sine 2 omega t upon 2 omega, and it has a limit 0 to t. Put the values. Here is r I naught square upon 2, r I naught square upon 2. Okay, now this is equal to r I naught square upon 2, and this is t minus 0, that is equal to t, minus sine 2 omega t. When we put t here, what is 2 omega? Omega is 2 pi upon t. So this is sine 2 into 2, 4 pi, or we can put it simply like this, 2 into 2 pi upon t. This is omega, and in this t we put this value of t, टी अपॉन फोर ओमेगा माइनस पुट दिस वैल्यू जीरो साइन जीरो अपॉन टू ओमेगा. ओके नाउ साइन जीरो इज जीरो, दिस इज कैंसल्ड, साइन फोर पाई इज अगेन जीरो, सो दिस इज जीरो, दिस इज जीरो, दिस टोटल बिकम जीरो. व्हाट रिमेन्स इज टी आर आई नॉट स्क्वेयर टी अपॉन टू. दिस इज वर्क डन बाय एसी. नाउ इफ दिस इज वर्क डन बाय एसी देन दिस शुड बी इक्वल टू द इफेक्टिव वैल्यूज वर्क डन. वर्क डन बाय इफेक्टिव वैल्यू, वर्क डन बाय इफेक्टिव वैल्यू work done by effective value is during time period is I square, I will write it here, work done by effective value is I effective square into R into time, this. But both this work done by effective value and by AC value should be same, then only we will call it effective value. So these two are same. If these two are same, then we can write it in an equation. That equation will be I effective square R T is equal to R I naught square T divided by 2. Very simply, R T, R T. Cancel. So I effective is equal to I naught upon root 2. We know that this effective value is RMS value. So in other terms we can write it I RMS is equal to I naught upon root 2. So if there is an AC which is changing its current 0 ampere to 10 ampere, 0 ampere to 10 ampere, 0, 10, 0, 10, then it is doing certain work, that work is equivalent to certain steady current. How much is that steady current? We can find out here because we know the peak value 10. If we put 10 here, so how much this will be? Okay, this 1 upon root 2, we divide, we make it into decimal, so we find that I RMS is equal to 0.707 I naught. This 0.707 I naught. Okay, remember this and this both for conversion of RMS to peak and peak to RMS, because this you will have to do as a thumb rule many times. Now I am asking you, the peak value of current is 10. Put peak value 10 here and this will become I RMS is equal to 7.07. When peak value is equal to 10, then I RMS is 7.07, or we can say it is I effective. That means 10 ampere of 10 peak value AC is doing the work equivalent to 7.07 ampere of the steady current. Why it is not working up to 10? Because most of the time it is 0. Sometimes it is 5. Sometimes it is 10. So average it work how much? It work equal to 7 ampere steady current as if. So we will call that this AC is, we won't say it is 0 to 10. We say this is AC current 7.07 or 7. So a 7 ampere AC, what does it mean? In fact, it is changing 0, 10, 0, minus 10, 0. But we are telling what? 7 amperes. So all our powers, work done, energy, everything is calculated with this value, 7. So this is effective value, this is RMS value. Whenever we quote, whenever we say how much current this motor is taking, then we always inform RMS value. If you ask me how much current this pump takes, I tell you this pump is taking 13 ampere. This is running by AC. So you will ask, is this RMS value or is it peak value? I don't tell you. So we have made it a rule that if we are telling you value of AC current and we don't inform you what type of value it is, then it is RMS value, because that is the effective value. So if I ask you how much this press iron, how much current it takes, you say it takes 2 current. I won't ask you whether it is peak or average or what, because I know if you have not told anything, it is RMS value, effective value. So in our language, whenever we quote RMS without speaking. If it is a peak value, then I have to tell you. So if nothing is written in the question, nothing is given in the information, we take it as effective value or RMS value. The same thing goes for EMF also. AC EMF, the peak EMF is E naught. Average EMF is E RMS or E effective, this is upon root 2, or 0.707 E is equal to 0.707 E naught, peak value, EMF voltage. Now, I tell you, in our house, the electricity board is supplying AC. The voltage of AC, you all know, it is 220 volt. If it is a 220 volt supply, then tell me, what is this 220 volt, which value it is? Is it peak value or is it RMS value? Because I have not told anything, surely it is effective, that is RMS value. So 220 volt in our household supply is RMS value of the potential difference, RMS value of the EMF. But you know that RMS value is always smaller than the peak value. RMS value 0.7 is always smaller than the peak value. That means our household supply has actually larger peak value, because the average is 220. Average from 0 to peak value, that is 220. Then what is the peak value? It should be higher than that, and it's a very valid question. The question says, find out peak value of voltage in our household supply. Find out peak value of voltage in our household supply. In household supply, ERMS, that is voltage effective, is 220 volt. Then how much is E peak value? So we know E naught is equal to, from that relation, E naught is equal to ERMS multiplied by root 2. That is ERMS 220 multiplied by root 2. So in our household, what we are telling you, that this is a 220 volt supply. This is not 220 volt supply. It is a variable supply of AC which changes from 0 to 311. 0, 311. 0, 311. So its peak value is 311. Its value is, minimum value is 0. And the average is 220, what we are quoting. Now, if I ask you, we are touching a wire which has got 220 volt DC. We are touching another wire which is having 220 volt AC. Both gives us a shock. Which shock is more fatal? Which is more fatal? 220 volt DC or 220 volt AC? Volt means what? Pressure, tension. which is more dangerous? So answer is AC is more dangerous. Why AC is more dangerous? Because AC in 1 second for 50 times AC touch the value 311 volt. So when you touch it, how much is the shock it is going to pinch? 311. In DC, how much it is going to push you? With 220. In AC, 311. So AC is more fatal. Shock of AC is more fatal than DC.
Though it is said so, there is one more concept about AC, that AC current falls to natural zero 2 times in a cycle. Hence, there is a chance to cut out a particular circuit 2 times in a cycle when AC falls to its natural zero.